Hello friends, in this video we will study surface of revolution. So now first we will write definition for surface of revolution. So basically it is an axis symmetric surface that can be modeled only on axis symmetric objects. So for surface of revolution, the axis symmetric objects play a important role, which means that the surface of revolution can only done for axis symmetric objects. Axis symmetric object is basically rectangle, triangle, trapezium. These are all axis symmetric objects. So it is generated by rotating a planar wireframe entity in a space about the axis of symmetry with certain height. So we can take one example how surface of revolution takes place. So this is the axis of rotation, and I will draw a right angle triangle on this axis of rotation of distance x. So when I will revolve this triangle about this axis of rotation, it will get generated into solid cone. You can see after revolving this triangle by 360 degree rotation, it develops a solid cone. This is the solid cone. Initially it was x, now it is converted into 2x. So we can take one more example of rectangle. So first I will draw the axis of rotation. Now I am drawing the rectangle on this axis of rotation, which lie on the axis of rotation. So after revolving this rectangle about its axis of rotation by 360 degree, a solid cylinder is generated. You can see, so this is axis of rotation. After revolving this rectangle, a solid cylinder is generated. If we do for rectangle which is away from axis of rotation, so this is the axis of rotation and this is the rectangle which is away from axis of rotation. So if I will rotate, let's say the side is A, if I will rotate this rectangle about this axis of rotation by 360 degree, a hollow cylinder is generated. You can see this is the axis of rotation. So this is the outer cylinder. And this is the inner cylinder, which means that the rectangle which is away from this axis of rotation and it is rotated by a revolve by 360 degree, the geometry which develops is called as hollow cylinder. So one more example we will take of trapezium. So this is the axis of rotation and this is the trapezium. if I will rotate this trapezium about its axis of rotation by 360 degrees, the geometry which will generated will be frustum, solid frustum. You can see after rotating or revolving this trapezium about this axis of rotation, so it will develop a solid frustum.